Sri Krishna Marries Rukmini. Sage Sukha said, one king called Raivata had a single daughter. She was very beautiful and was blooming with youthfulness. He loved her greatly. He wanted to get a good alliance for her marriage. He searched all over the world but could not find, as per his estimation, a suitable husband for her. To avoid further worry, he took her to Brahma, waited a little for getting his audience, and submitted his anxiety to him. Brahma told him that after he had left the earth and before he reached Brahmaloka, so many generations had come and gone on the earth, and the husband intended for his daughter was no more. So Brahma advised the king to return to the earth quickly and to offer his daughter as wife to Adisesha, who was born as Balarama. Accordingly, Balarama married Revati, daughter of the king Raivata. Parikshit inquired, O sage, you have also told me that Sri Krishna carried away Rukmini in a swayamvara, vanquishing all the kings assembled there, and married her. How could have Sri Krishna carried away Rukmini single-handed when armies after armies were standing in attendance? Further, the stories of the Lord are so enchanting that the mind never gets satisfaction in hearing them. They appear as though quite new and strange. Please, therefore, elaborate the story for my sake. Hearing the stories of the Lord Vishnu is real ornament for the ears, not gold or diamonds. The stories bestow extreme satisfaction to the hearer. They destroy the sins of many births. They are auspicious. They lead to emancipation. Then the sage began to narrate the story of how Sri Krishna married Rukmini. The marriage of Rukmini with Sri Krishna, which is popularly known as Rukmini Kalyana, is an allegorical depiction of the romantic reunion of the soul, Jiva, with the Self, the Supreme. Sri Krishna was the Supreme Self. Rukmini was the soul or Jiva. Bhishmaka was ignorance. Avidya, born in the body, Kundinapura. The offspring of Avidya was Ahankar. Rukmini, the eldest son, Ahankar, and had the friend called Dvesha as Sishupala. They had the support of Deho Aham, I am the body, feeling as Jarasandha. The soul born to ignorance was caught in the entanglements of these trio. But the soul, being mature, possessed Guru Kripa, the teacher's blessings. Shastra Kripa, the blessing of theoretical knowledge. Antakarna Kripa, by having a pure and evolved mind. And Ishvara Kripa, in the form of grace from the Lord. By self-effort for Purushartha, the soul was capable of snapping the entanglements of the above and aspire to unite with the Self, and the grace of the Self was equally forthcoming in lifting up the soul from its bonds, and the reunion was complete and successful. Bhishmaka was the king of Vidarbha. Kundinapura was his capital. He had 5 sons and 1 daughter. The eldest son was Rukmi, and the others were Rukmadhara, Rukmabahu, Rukmakesa, and Rukmanetra. The last and youngest was the daughter by name Rukmini. Rukmini was by nature very clever and highly intelligent. She used to hear about the stories and adventures of Sri Krishna even from her childhood, from learned men that used to visit her father's palace. She had come to the conclusion that Sri Krishna was Lord Vishnu himself, that she was the incarnation of Lakshmi, and Sri Krishna was her ideal husband. As Rukmini advanced in age and attained her youth, she was the center of attraction in the palace, and there was the topic of marriage. All were of the opinion of giving her in marriage to Sri Krishna, but Rukmi, the eldest son, stood against them all and wanted her to be given in marriage to Shishupala, his friend. Bhishmaka, the father, was helpless to alter the wish of his son. Rukmi was arrogant and powerful. He commanded that all preparations be made according to his wish. When Rukmini came to know that her brother was bent upon giving her in marriage to Shishupala and that her father was helpless to avert it, she evolved her own plans for her salvation. Rukmini was otherwise known as Vidarbi, the daughter of the king of Vidarbha. Vidarbi had been depicted as the soul with spiritual inclinations in the allegory of Puranjana. She decided on self-surrender or Charanagati. She called the family priest Agniyotana, who was her guru, friend and well-wisher. She requested him to proceed to Dwarka and convey her determination to Sri Krishna that she had decided to marry only Sri Krishna and none else, otherwise to cast off her body, birth after birth, till her wish was accomplished. She requested Sri Krishna to come to the Swayamvara to rescue her and make her his own. The Brahmin went to Dwarka, met Sri Krishna and then narrated the submission of Rukmini. Sri Krishna said that he had already resolved to marry Rukmini and that everything would be done to that end. King Bhishmaka had arranged a Swayamvara and invited all the kings, including Sri Krishna, and fixed the date of the marriage. He received the kings as and when they arrived and made all arrangements for their comfortable stay. Rukmi was happy with the arrival of Shishupala, Jarasandha and other friends of his. Sri Krishna arrived just in time for the occasion and he was also duly received. On the wedding day, the bride, Rukmini, was duly bathed, neatly dressed and elaborately decorated for a devotional procession. She had to proceed to the royal temple and worship goddess Uma Maheshwari. The procession reached the temple. She worshipped the goddess with great devotion and solemnity. There again, she prayed to the goddess to make Sri Krishna her husband and not to forget and forsake her in that last moment. Then the procession made its return. Rukmini started with her maids back to the place on foot. She was passing along the main road where all the kings and princes had assembled on either side. As she was moving, she was searching as to where Sri Krishna was among those assembled. She had already heard from the Brahmin priest that he had arrived. Not far away, she saw him seated in a chariot. She could not lift her eyes off from his gaze. As she approached nearer, Sri Krishna got down from his car, lifted Rukmini up like a lamb, seated her in his chariot, and drove it away at full speed. The other kings were not able to believe their own eyes. They could not gauge what had taken place. They were stunned by the beauty of Rukmini on the one side and by the daring action of Sri Krishna on the other. By the time they could regain their senses, Sri Krishna had travelled a long distance. He was joined by Balarama, who anticipated trouble at the Swayamvara and so had come with a big army. Meanwhile, Rukmi heard of the daring act of Sri Krishna. He could not brook the insult inflicted on him by Sri Krishna's behavior. He collected all the kings, including Shishupala and Jarasandha, and pursued Sri Krishna. Balarama gave them a pitched battle and vanquished all of them. The surviving kings like Jarasandha and others met together under the shade of a tree and consoled Shishupala for the loss of a bride. They congratulated him that he was having his head over his neck. Rukmi would not accept defeat. He chased Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna, observing his foolishness, halted there, killed the horses of Rukmi, destroyed his car, broke all his weapons, and caught him by the tuft. He shaved his hair with his sword, making him ugly to look at. Meanwhile, Rukmini interceded. She was much afraid for the life of her brother. She begged Sri Krishna to take pity on her and spare the life of Rukmini, lest their parents would be bereaved for a son, instead of being happy that the Lord had become their son-in-law. Balarama had joined them by this time and was observing the fate of Rukmini. He got down and released Rukmini from the chariot of Sri Krishna, to which he was bound with strings by Sri Krishna, and allowed him to go back home. He saw the frightened condition of Rukmini and consoled her that each soul suffers good or bad fruits according to its own previous actions and tendencies. And so Sri Krishna need not be considered as cruel for dispensing the fruits of her brother's reactions. Rukmini, vanquished, dishonored and disfigured, was bubbling with grudge against Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna, Rukmini and Balarama left him behind and proceeded to Dwaraka, where the wedding of Sri Krishna and Rukmini was celebrated on a grand scale. Many kings and princes from all over the country had come to witness the same with great love and devotion.